Hey there, P&W fans. Welcome to P&W Counter Reviews, and thanks for joining us for another review. Today we're doing another subscription box. These guys reached out to us and sent us their glass pack. This is it's the Toker Pack. And the first thing you see in the box when you open it is that Toker Pack, the $35 glass pack. Before we got this, I had no idea what I got. And this is the first negative of this. And I hope to God that this is not how they're sending their subscriptions every month. I got a very nondescript brown box. Now, we like that part of it because we don't want the mailman knowing that we're about to chief it up on some new glass. But what you don't see is a business name on there at all, anywhere. I had no idea what I got in the mail. I had no idea who John B. was. I had no idea that I knew anybody in Ohio. I didn't know what I was getting. So then I opened it up, and I pulled this out to show you right away so you saw what it was. But this was at the very bottom of the box. I still had no idea what I was getting. So when I opened the box, this was the first thing I pulled out, and I realized, okay, I've got a stoner box on my hands. So now let's do the unpack and reveal. First thing is this really oddly wrapped grinder. Rubber band, super, super thin packing material. Now it's plastic, so it's not that big of a deal, but then wrapped in it as you're unwrapping this is a hempwick spool. Now it's already wrapped around the case for a lighter. It's just designed for to fit right over a Bic. So it's nice. It's a lot of hemp wick, so that's kind of cool, but odd spot for it. Keep opening it up, and then you get this grinder. And I have never actually had a plastic grinder in my hands before. I've seen them, but I've never actually had one in my hands. This is the crappiest thing I've ever seen for grinding herb in my life. I have not used it yet. As you can see, we do these as an unpack and reveal, so it's clean, but it's coated with this odd film. It feels almost greasy, and it is, I mean, the spikes are pokey, but I don't see how this is going to really shred all that kind of weed. It fits together really weird. There's air that gets forced out, and it doesn't want to stay all the way in. You have to keep pushing to keep it together. That spins really easily on there. It's just really weird. I've never had one in my hands. Like I said, that's a really weird grinder. To top it all off, there's no keep catcher on that, which makes that an instant, like, with the construction and everything. That's like a two. That's junk. Sorry, Toker Box, but that's junk, and you need to do better. Moving on, we have this pile of bubble wrap. Again, wrapped in a rubber band. And if you get a Toker Pack and this is what you get and you see this, be careful. There's no instruction, there's no nothing, there's no packing list. I didn't know what I was getting, so I started unwrapping. You unwrap. And cool, it's a bunch of bubble wrap, glad for the packaging. Then you again have super thin packing material. This is some bubble wrap wrapped around some more of this stuff and then packed with some tape. You start unwrapping this, and very quickly right here you see there's something wrapped in there. You can see that there's some glass in there, so you know to look, but with no packing list I didn't know how much to look. So I was standing there when I unwrapped this the first time. And this glass, God, I'm totally blanking on the name of this, glass blunt is, fell out and hit the ground. And it shattered. I'm not even going to open this, but let me see if I can get this closer to the camera. And you can see the pieces. I mean, this thing was destroyed, and it fell less than 2 feet. It goes to speak to the quality of the glass that this was, but honestly, I can't speak to the quality because I'm not even going to unwrap this because it's destroyed. Bad packaging again. But that definitely made me go, oh crap. Laid it on the table and continued to unwrap. Next thing you unpack is a little mini glass pipe. Honestly, this is actually fairly durable. It's thick glass. The The color scheme is orange and yellow and blue, and it's a tiny little sneaker toker. I hate this size of pipe myself, but I know a lot of people that like these. And then this is the last piece that you get. And again, it's another pipe, blunt, pipe, grinder, Hempwick. So that's what you get. It's a bunch of dry smoking, and if you've watched any of our other reviews, you know I'm not a big fan of that, but it is what it is. It's a glass box, which we liked, and this pipe is the crowning pipe. Now, this one's nice. It's got a lot of different glass pieces. It's been pulled and stretched and twisted. It's good quality. I mean, listen to this. It's a good piece of glass. I like this pipe. This is a pipe that I would gift. I would use myself if I needed one. I don't, because I know you guys saw that pumpkin one that we got from Chameleon from the Stash Box. So that's our personal collection right now. So this one, we would be happy to actually recommend this pipe. This one, same quality, just much smaller. So again, quality piece. I just don't like that style. And then finally, the glass blunt that just, like I said, it fell less than 2 feet and was destroyed. So this is the Toker Pack. They call it the $35 glass pack. And probably worth a little bit more than $35 in the long run. You've got to just make sure that you read the review down below to see everything. We'll do the comparable value and everything like we do for the other boxes. This one's already, I can tell you, not going to get our PNW seal of approval, or the badge of approval, between the packaging and the fact that this broke and was junk. I mean, there's a lot of things that they need to improve if they're going to do a monthly subscription on this. So, here's a follow-up to our Dank Mail. We're going to continue to follow up with these as we get them. In the end, though, the Toker Pack, you probably want to look for another one. Go to pnwcr.com/dank-mail and read our Dank Mail review, and you can see the 6 ones that we recommend the most. We've also done some other follow-ups, so check those out. Thanks for joining us, PNW fans. We'll catch you next time.